Well, more than 50,000 people are packing to St Peter's Square in Vatican City for our moment in history. And across Australia, the faithful have gathered to celebrate the canonisation of Mary MacKillop, Australia's first Catholic saint. We have reporters at the Vatican, as well as at Mary's tomb in Sydney and in Panola, South Australia. Let's go now first to Danny Alaisdell at the Vatican. And Danny, the service will begin in just a few hours. Tell us what's happening there right now.
Well, we can already see from our vantage point the thousands of pilgrims just this second allowed to make their way into St Peter's Square after lining the perimeter for a long time. There's a crowd of 50,000 expected, so they had to get here early and they are prepared to stand and strain for any view they can get. Now, the rain has held off. It is here in fits and starts, I'm sure, after many prayers from the pilgrims to Mother Mary overnight. It does seem fairly fine, so they're hoping that clears up, and they've waited 85 years for this. So all that's left to do now, once they're inside, is to wait just a little bit longer to see Australia's very first Catholic saint.
St Peter's Square is ready, and so is Kathleen Evans. Her recovery from cancer was accepted as Mary's second miracle. Now she's preparing to say thank you in front of the Pope and 50,000 pilgrims. Some of them spent canonisation eve shuffling in a queue of biblical proportions.
Probably is the longest line. It is moving quick, but it is very long line.
Waiting their turn for a tour under the watchful eye of our saint-to-be. Even she couldn't protect rowdy Aussies from the Swiss Guard.
I'm afraid we made a bit of noise and we were told by the guards to get out. So we've been evicted from St Peter's.
But there was plenty to do outside too, like mob Kevin Rudd.
Oh my God!
The foreign minister treated like a rock star in Rome.
To be fair, Julia's with me.
Oh, here she is. Come here.
And all Australians are in political life and they're greeted in the streets.
Just not necessarily this enthusiastically.
While he clearly enjoyed the attention, as Kevin Rudd rightly said, he's not the star of this show. It's all about Mary MacKillop, her life and her legacy.
Both were celebrated in a special concert, her saintly story told through song, drama.
We must begin our order in Panola. You know you can't miss MacKillop. You know that this is what God wants of you.
Dance. And a little Catholic comedy. In Vatican City, Danny Alaisdell, 10 News.
All jokes aside, this is of course a serious affair, as are all services presided over by the Pope. TEN's Emma Dallimore is down there somewhere in the thick of it, preparing to cover the ceremony itself. But earlier, she spent some time following Mary's history and walking in her footsteps.
She was a pioneer, a battler, a saviour, who from humble beginnings gave hope to millions.
We've got someone to look up to now, a saint in Australia, first saint.
She was born Mary Helen MacKillop in 1842 and by 14 was working to support her needy family, a calling that became a devotion. In 1866, Mary co-founded the Sisters of St Joseph of the Sacred Heart, and her Josephites spread through Australia, providing education, care and hope to some of our neediest families. But her passion brought controversy. Branded disobedient, even an alcoholic, Mary was excommunicated from the church in 1871. Only recently it suggested it was because of her refusal to cover up child abuse. But she was exonerated a year later and packed her bags for Rome. Mary MacKillop walked these very streets back in 1873 on a mission to ensure the Sisters of St Joseph had official approval. She lived just down the road from the famous Spanish Steps after spending 2 months on a boat just getting here.
Right across the capital, Mary's faithful now follow her path.
You know, it's very soulful. It's like a dream. It's like a dream for me that I have to go home and relive to take it all in.
When Mary died in 1909, mourners jostled to touch her body, and a cardinal proclaimed he'd assisted at the deathbed of a saint. A century on, he's been proven right. In Vatican City, Emma Dallimore, 10 News.
Now, in a short while, everybody will have to be in place. They'll have a period of about half an hour of preparation, prayers and singing, waiting for Pope Benedict XVI, and for that moment that he pronounces Mary MacKillop, our St. Mary of the Cross.
Thank you so much, Danny. Danielle Isdale reporting there. Of course, we'll cross to Danny throughout the evening for special canonisation updates. And pilgrims were keen to get as close as possible to Mother Mary as they flocked to her tomb in North Sydney. Our reporter Melinda Nusifora is there and she joins us now. Melinda, how is Mary's sainthood being celebrated there? It's a very exciting time.
Well, Tash, it's safe to say that it's almost a festival mood here at Mary MacKillop Place in North Sydney. People have been cheering, they've been singing, waving Mary MacKillop flags and carrying balloons. Numbers have easily exceeded expectations and it was standing room only at masses here all throughout the day. The crowd is now preparing itself in front of live screens at the live sites across the city so they can get a glimpse of the exact moment when Mary MacKillop becomes St. Mary of the Cross.
Historic and holy, a day Catholics across Sydney queued to be part of.
Very exciting day, and I want my children just to be happy like I feel happy for Mary MacKillop.
More than 10,000 pilgrims flocked to the Mary MacKillop Chapel in North Sydney, the final resting place of Australia's first Catholic saint.
We wanted to be where she was.
Praying for comfort and giving thanks, at times her tomb was a solemn shrine. But the mood wasn't sombre for long, it was a day to rejoice. Her canonisation is, in itself, a miracle to some.
I didn't think I'd be alive to recognise it.
Three outdoor masses were celebrated on the grounds and believers were sure Mary was close by.
It's a beautiful day. I keep in prayer for today to be sunny days.
A festive display of faith filled the forecourt of Sydney's St Mary's Cathedral.
It's just wonderful. It just brings tears to our eyes.
The emotion is sure to build as the Vatican ceremony is broadcast live. Melinda Nusifora, 10 News.
And the tiny South Australian town of Panola has also come alive. Thousands of pilgrims have flooded in to join celebrations in the place so important to Mary MacKillop's legacy. 10's Fiona Clark is there. Fiona, a very special time for residents there.
Look, they are very excited, but there is also a sense of disbelief that the day has finally arrived. The people here have put so much work into being ready for today, and the festivities have been going all day. Large parts of the town are blocked off to make room for them. At the moment, the formal mass is underway. There are about 4,000 people here at the moment, but more are arriving all the time. Busloads have been pouring in all day. Many people have come because of their faith, but others have come to pay tribute to a pioneering woman and others to celebrate Panola. They will all witness the broadcast live from the Vatican later tonight. The Vatican flag is now flying next to the town's church. It was an official gift. But many people here say that today, for today at least, Panola is the next best thing to Rome.
The morning began with quiet reflection among those for whom today matters most.
This is a recognition that I think is wonderful for us as Sisters of St. Joseph, but for our Australian nation.
Cause for an entire community to celebrate. These children attend the Mary MacKillop School, just 100 metres from where she opened her first schoolhouse 143 years ago.
What do you know about Mary MacKillop?
She was kind, she was helpful.
The people of Panola have always known the story of Mary MacKillop. Today, as the Vatican flag was raised alongside their church, they were delighted to share that story with the world.
There it is next to our church in Panola. I can't believe it.
A lot of people want to be in Rome, but this is the next best thing.
All walks of life united.
To me, it means the world. Yes, it's very nice to have an Australian.
A celebratory mass in the place where it all began. In Panola, Fiona Clark, 10 News.
And in the state where Mother Mary was born, thousands of Victorians gathered to participate in prayer, then a parade. The faithful are already gathering to watch the canonisation live from Vatican City.
Sister Mary's life began in Victoria, so the state led celebrations to commemorate the daughter of migrant parents who will be Australia's first saint.
This is the very first celebration in Australia, probably the first in the world, this Mass.
Standing room only for morning Mass.
In your righteousness deliver me.
Paying tribute to Mary's city of birth and rural upbringing.
Mary loved life on the farm and became a skilled horse rider.
Melburnians then marched from Mary MacKillop's birthplace in Fitzroy to the exhibition building in Carlton, where they'll watch the canonisation telecast live, along with tens of thousands of other Australians this evening.
Although not religious, the Prime Minister declared the event an historic achievement worth celebrating.
And I think every Australian would say that Mary was a great Australian and a great believer in the power of education.
And a special day deserves a special song.
Oh, Mary.
Alicia McMillan, 10 News.